Evening, guys. Welcome back to The Joy of Resin. Let's see. What am I doing? I have this new mold. By the way, I also have a self-leveling tray now. Woo! Very exciting day for me. I have my new mold. This big old thing right here. And I'm going to do stuff with it. Shit. Sorry, guys. All right, now that's over with. Okay, so I have need of a bigger workstation. Okay, so I have new mold. I got some pigment ink, pigment resin, and I have some clear. And I'm going to start with just a thin layer of clear along the bottom so that I can put some stones in, and then we're going to go from there. So. That'll do. Now I just need to add my pigment to this. All right, so I'm just going to put a couple of these little glow-in-the-dark stones down in the corners. So, I tried something new today. I have a reptile cage heating mat that a friend of mine sent me a while back that I've used it once or twice, but never to really good effect. I kind of originally didn't give it the time it needed to properly heat up, so I just, too impatient, gave it a while, gave up on it. But, you know, this time I turned it on as soon as I got home, let it heat up while I figured out what I was going to do, got all my supplies ready, and it actually got pretty much all of the bubbles out of the resin just fine. So, heating mat for the win. Once again, thank you, my friend. Okay, all right, got that. To just add some of these other little mineral stones down here along the edges. Okay, is that not everything everywhere all at once? Sorry, don't sue me. Okay, let's kind of push these down in there. Not the easiest mold to get rocks down into. Okay, getting closer. All right, I think that's everything. Okay. All right. Now that that fun part is over with, see, I've got my colors to deal with. I've got the yellow, which has been fairly front and center, so let's start with that. I'm gonna make the star yellow, because, you know, I'm predictable. And then we're going to do, let's see, which, what was it? The purple was, okay, so I'm trying to juxtapose because I've got two of these that are neon and two of these that are just normal pigments. So purple and I think it was the green are the ones that are neon. Okay, so then red. made way too much resin. And then lastly, we have the green. Okay, now let's try to top this thing up. Hopefully without overflowing. Still have some wiggle room. Okay. All right. Now, what am I going to do with all the rest of this? Well, obviously, I've got a backup project. So, let's see. So, I had the... I have the container mold, which I just replaced because it was indeed misshapen and the pieces did not fit together. So, I... got on Amazon and got a replacement, and hopefully this one will actually work as intended. So let's find out how it works. Alright, so just gonna play four corners over here. Let me just go back and forth. Until we fill it up. Hit this with the heat gun real quick and go put it in the closet. this size. I need both hands, so let me make sure the closet door is open for me. Yeah, oh, there's something floating in there. I'm not down for that. There we go. Alright, wish me luck. Okay, success. Now you, what are you doing? Okay. Still got a little bit of room in this thing. Pretty sure this thing is still uneven. The mold, I mean. It's just... Alright. Only so much I can do. So what am I going to do with the rest of this stuff? I need another mold. No, yes, I'm going to make a really gay skull. Yikes. It's full of hair. Starting to get a little goopy. I think I'm running out of time. Man, ever since I stopped doing the large batch and then break it off, mixing a large batch of resin, and then breaking it off into little pieces where I just have to mix up the dye. I have not had a single flash curing incident, so that was obviously the right instructions for my friend to give me. My best friend taught me that one. She actually kind of ripped me a new one over it. And considering how much resin I was wasting, she was in the right to do so. So, thank you, best friend. I'm grateful. Last but not least, the purple. Okay, we have our new Dumbskull. Not to be confused with the Numbskull, which is me. Okay, so that's that. Let me hit these with the heat gun real quick. You guys see those real quick? Pretty good. Okay, that is all I have to say about that. All right, so let me put this stuff away and clean up, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Have a good night, guys.